Alex Pereira managed to make a lot of noise when he defeated Israel Adesanya for the third time and became the middleweight champion. But in the second fight, according to the MMA rule, the former champion was able to regain his belt by stopping the Brazilian, and now each of the fighters is waiting for different paths. Pereira is going to move up a category, and as for me, he could be greeted by Magomed Ankalaev. Hello everyone, fighters are with you MMA Predictions channel. In this video, I will give a prediction for one of the top fights between Magomed Ankalaev and former middleweight champion Alex Pereira. But before starting this video, do not forget to subscribe to the channel and like it so that as many fans as possible can watch this episode. Magomed Ankalaev's career was just perfect, victory after victory, and his performance shocked many fans. And after a series of such performances, he was finally given the right to fight for the belt. His opponent was Jan Blachowicz. Since there was no champion in this weight class, they fought for the vacant belt. The fight itself was not as spectacular as everyone expected. The fighters were cautious, and there were a minimum of blows, but still Magomed's advantages in that fight were visible to the naked eye. But the judges decided otherwise, declaring a draw, so Ankalaev missed the opportunity to become another champion from Dagestan. After, as you probably already know, two more contenders, Jamal Hill and Glover Teixeira, challenged the title. Hill left no chance to the Brazilian in that fight, destroying him in each of the rounds and eventually taking the status of the undisputed champion. Ankalaev has been looking for an opponent as a comeback for a long time, but again, no one wants to enter the octagon with him. But just recently, after the defeat of Adesanya, Alex Pereira decided not to torture his body with a weight carrier anymore and moved to light heavyweight. Pereira is an eminent athlete and, of course, someone from the bottom of the ratings will not suit him. Most likely the Brazilian will choose opponents from the top five, and perhaps his gaze can pay attention to Magomed Ankalaev. He only recently fought for the belt, and before that he had a brilliant series of victories. Plus, he is at the top of his division, in my opinion. This is an ideal layout, since it is unlikely that anyone will give him a title right away. He needs to have at least one fight to prove that he is the main contender for the belt. Both fighters are coming after not the most confident fights, and they will clearly have the motivation to show a show. Plus, both like to work in the rack. Yes, Ankalaev can fight, but for the most part he specializes in hands. And now that I have told the background of this fight, let's analyze it to the smallest details to understand who is worthy of fighting for the title next. Percussion style. Well, as usual, we start with a punch, and Magomed is the first in line. Well, what can I say about him? His last fight greatly spoiled his reputation as a knockout and tough striker. Before the fight with Jan Blachowicz, Magomed showed a brilliant performance on his hands. No one in the light heavyweight division had such accuracy, speed, and strength. Ankalaev is a disciplined fighter, and almost always he does everything according to the instructions. And in most of his fights, he simply did not give his opponent a chance to succeed. But in the last fight, Blachowicz opened holes in the game of the Dagestanian. The first thing that Pereira should take a closer look at is, of course, low kicks. Remember how Jan was able to knock out Ankalaev's leg, and Blachowicz for a minute was never famous for his kicks. Now let's move on to the striking technique of the Brazilian, who has managed to make a lot of noise lately. He flew into the UFC brightly, knocking out with a shiny knee in the air, then masterfully caught the ever-chattering Sean Strickland, and was able to rise from the ashes and knock out Israel Adesanya. You can see for yourself in MMA, he is not so long, but what he was able to demonstrate is worthy of respect. Now let's go back to low kicks, as we know Alex is a kickboxer, and of course most of the knockouts in this sport were brought to him by his kicks. Even Adesanya, he was able to cause a lot of problems with such punches, and here comes a fighter who in the last fight had big problems with this punch. Given how healthy the Brazilian's legs are, this could be a real problem for Ankalaev. A couple of missed from Pereira could lead to the fact that Magomed will not be able to properly stand on his own too. and the referee will have to stop the fight. Also, in addition to low Pereira, you can add kicks to the body and head. I think he will clearly be able to surprise Magomed and even shake him a couple of times with such techniques. Playing from the bottom. Let's move on. Now we have the wrestling sphere in turn, and this time we will start with Alex Pereira, who has a hell of a lot of problems in this path, and it is because of his lack of experience with wrestlers that he will face big problems. At the beginning of his career, as you may remember, Pereira was declassed from below. Then he decided to leave this sport, but still after he returned, and since then he has not entered the octagon with an elite wrestler, but even this did not prevent him from missing takedowns. A clear example of this is the fight against Izzy, in which the champion has already transferred an inexperienced challenger over and over again. It would be fine if he was transferred and held by a conditional Marvin Vittori, but a basic striker, man, you need to do something urgently, otherwise you will not stay in the UFC for long. Let's move on to Magomed Ankalaev's wrestling skills, but here everything is radically the opposite. Yes, I remember I said that Ankalaev is first of all a striker and then a wrestler, but this does not negate the fact that he will not transfer Pereira. The Brazilian showed everything himself. It is absolutely not difficult to translate him, and therefore I am 100% sure Magomed will spam with translations. Let's remember Maggi's last fight, in which everything went badly for him. But because of his wrestling training, he transferred the pole and dominated for 2 rounds, giving no chance to get up and do anything. And given that Jan is not the last man in the fight, this can be said to be a plus for Magomed. And if he translated the pole, then Pereira should not be difficult for him to quit and transfer. In this path, of course, Magomed will be considered the favorite, who is simply head and shoulders above the Brazilian. And as soon as they are there, Alex will be finished. Cardio spirit. Let's move on, and the next point is the breather of athletes, where we will start with Magomed Ankalaev. I can safely declare, shows himself at long distances without any problems. Yes, maybe he does not have such experience as, for example, Adesanya, but Mago is just starting and he has the prerequisites for a successful career. What can I say about Pereira's stamina? He went through all 25 minutes once in the first fight against Israel, where he showed himself as a smart and worthwhile fighter who can easily pass all the allotted rounds. But still, Ankalaev has more experience and therefore he will be the favorite. As for the spirit, I will again believe in Magomed more, which after the last fight was very disappointed, and clearly it will be charged to show a super fight. Forecast. I think that Magomed Ankalaev will win this fight, and most likely ahead of schedule. From the very first round he will look for a takedown, and sooner or later he will achieve his goal, and Pereira will be at the bottom. He will exhaust him for a couple of rounds, and then he will choke him in the 3 minutes 4 rounds.